Like humans, spacecraft also go to a cemetery when they die, only this one isn't in a memorial park. It's here, this super remote spot in the Pacific Ocean that's actually known as the Spacecraft Cemetery. It's the furthest point on the globe from any human civilization, which means it is the safest place to have hot metal falling from the sky. Humans have purposefully crashed hundreds of spaceships at this spot, which is super cool, if kind of sad. The old adage of what goes up must come down applies to things in space too. Granted, not all of them. A spacecraft launched with enough velocity on the right trajectory won't come back to Earth, but things in Earth orbit will, like China's prototype space station Tiangong-1, which is expected to fall back to Earth in late March or early April of 2018. The unusual thing here is it's going to do that out of control, which raises the question of what happens when spacecraft die and have to come home. We have to do something with old space equipment, because most of the time it's going to come down no matter what we do. Satellites and space stations orbit because of their speed, about 17,500 miles an hour, and that balances against the pull of gravity. The higher the orbit, the more stable it is, too. That's because low Earth orbit isn't a perfect vacuum. There's no hard line where our atmosphere ends. Instead, it gradually peters out, meaning there's a thin veil of molecules that extends to where some satellites do orbit. Those molecules create drag, slowing the satellites until they can't keep up the fight against the pull of gravity, and they re-enter the atmosphere. This also happens in the region where the International Space Station orbits, by the way, about 200 miles above the planet. So, to keep satellites in orbit, we need to boost them continuously. Small bursts of speed kick satellites and stations up just enough to offset the drag of the upper atmosphere. Since most satellites and space stations are designed with a limited lifetime, mission planners have to figure out exactly how to bring them home before they're even launched. When they're ready to die, retro rockets fire against the direction of travel, slowing the payload deliberately and starting re-entry into the atmosphere where most small satellites just burn up. But there is another scenario. If a satellite or space station is dead or nearly out of fuel, things can get a little more complicated. Without power, engineers can't control the deorbit burn to bring it down in a predictable place. They have to cross their fingers and hope that it won't fall over a populated area. This is exactly where we're going with Tiangong-1. Engineers dealing with the station can map its orbit and predict when it might come down, but they can't predict every atmospheric disturbance that will affect exactly where on Earth it will land. The station itself is about 34 feet long and weighs close to 19,000 pounds, which means a fair bit of it is expected to burn up on re-entry, but large pieces could reach Earth. That mass, falling fast, could do some damage. Fatal damage if it hits a person, but it's a very slim chance. Luckily, most of the planet is ocean, and there are more unpopulated areas than cities in the world, so you really shouldn't have to worry. Leftover spacecraft are a big deal. Burning up or crashing is nice because otherwise they just hang out and get in the way of new missions or future vacations. Learn more here. Satellites orbiting too high to bring home are put into a graveyard orbit some 22,000 miles up, where they'll be out of the way. Thanks for watching.